apa nih, hantar barang?
Tak ada barang, tak ada barang. Nak jumpa orang.
Nak jumpa orang.
Nak jumpa orang dekat rumah.
Bos, tak tahu boleh buat belakang.
Apa dia?
Kereta nombor, boleh buat kamu.
You said that you've been through an injury, right? This some question is about personal about me because I had 3 ACLs.
Oh my god!
So I had 3 major injuries.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
But all on one foot or
left,
one
right,
leg or
right.
Both?
Yeah.
Serious. Left, right, and then
yeah.
right again.
Yeah.
Oh man.
So as a player, I mean, like sometimes I went to like 1.5 years of rehab.
Yeah, it's very difficult.
Total. And. Yeah. Sometimes I feel like football is not for me. Maybe sometimes I feel like giving up. But do you have any like motivations or for people out there who's constantly getting injured?
Yeah, it's very difficult. You know, I've not experienced as you know. I've been touch wood. I've been fortunate enough that I only had one bad injury when I was young, and it was shin splints, which kept me out for about 8 months. I had to have an operation on my shin to sort the muscle out, and that kept me out in 1995. I didn't play no games for Chelsea because of that, and it's very difficult. And obviously, you know, when you have an injury like ACL, the cruciate ligament, it's very difficult because you are hoping that it heals itself. You know, there's no major surgery that can. I think there's a lot of luck to be involved with ACL injury, whether you're going to play or not again. I don't think there's a direct procedure that says you fixed it and you're going to be fine. I think, you know, it's an injury that can come back again, as you've obviously experienced as well. All I would say to you was, you know, you have to mentally keep believing that you can do something, because I think the mind is a very powerful thing. And if you give up in the mind, I think your leg will always give up on you. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
But if you are strong mentally, I think your body, you know, follows your brain. And you have to be positive, and even in the darkest moments, you have to be positive and get through them. And I would always say to you, to young players anyway, I would always say, don't put all your eggs in one basket. So don't be just thinking only football. If you can prepare your mind by doing something else that can take you on, because with your career, it doesn't last for a long time. You're a long time retired in football. So always be prepared for, if it doesn't work, then I'm going to have something else to fall back on. That's the best thing, because as well as that helping you going forward and for the rest of your life, I also think sometimes you have to take a rest from thinking about your injury and have something else to focus on as well at the same time.
Well, talking about manager, what do you think about Sarri? I mean, like, Sarri had just like a few seasons only.
Yeah.
And I thought it was too short. I mean, like, as a fan, I went to few of the games when I was studying there.
Yeah.
So the fans didn't like Sarri that much. It was like all the chant was Sarri out and all that.
Yeah, it was interesting really, because I thought Sarri, when you look at his results, I thought he'd done very well. But the problem that I think was at Chelsea, because I covered a lot of the games while Sarri was in charge, was there was no connection with the supporters. And I think that was a big problem, and probably the reason why they went for Frank Lampard, because they knew him coming back to the club, there'd be an instant connect with the supporters straight away. And I think it was down to Sarri's, just his individual character, the way he come across in the press, the way he was. He didn't show a lot of passion in the way that he was on the touchline, etc. And when you've had people like Jose Mourinho previously, someone that shows a lot of passion, and even Villas-Boas before that as well, very passionate manager, I think the supporters didn't connect to him. So I don't think it was so much Sarri for his results, because he had a terrific season, you know, and probably, you know, his start was probably better than Frank Lampard's start from beginning of the season to December. Is probably a better start for him. But I just think the connection and the way that he was very rigid with his team formation, was very frustrating for the supporters because every game he played the exact same way
all
the time, and the supporters wanted to see something different and him be adaptable, and he never showed that, and I think that was his downfall, to be honest.
Yeah. Well, that's the one thing you can say about Lampard. When you go to watch Chelsea, you probably are going to be entertained that day, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Which is open to, you know, the reason why they're going to have ups and downs, because there's going to be games, you know, you can't always outscore your opposition, and especially when you come up against top teams. But certainly, you know, for the entertainment side of it, you saw that with his Derby team the season before, that, you know, you're going to be entertained, you're going to be disappointed, you're going to be happy sometimes.
Yeah,
that's the whole package of Frank Lampard, I believe, as a coach.
Well, at the end of the day, just coming off that a little bit, isn't results what you want? At the end of the day, you want your cups, you want to win the league.
Yeah, obviously you do, because Chelsea have been very much used to that over the last probably 15 or so, 20 years or so. You could even go back as far as when I played for the club. You know, that's when we started winning trophies, and it's been a regular thing under different managers. And the thing that the way that Chelsea have done it, no other football club can do it. Lots of clubs, they like to stick with one manager over a long period of time. Chelsea's changed the managers on average every 18 months and still been able to be successful at the same time. There's no other football club that's done this before. I agree with you, it is about winning things, but sometimes you have to look at the bigger picture and there's a transition that you have to go through. And I think Chelsea are going through this transition right now where, you know, they've had so many good young players over previous years that have not been able to get in the first team. And I think that's something that the board wanted to address this season, was getting players from the academy into the team. The only way you're going to do that is if you give it to a manager that is, one, brave enough to pick the players, because Frank Lampard didn't have to pick the players. When you look at the squad that he had this season, he had a very strong squad, even though there was a transfer embargo. So he's been brave enough to pick the young players to play in the games. And also, you have to have an understanding and a message from the board level that it may not go well, but don't worry about it. Keep believing in the process, and in a bigger picture, these players that play over the next 18 months to 2 years, by the time they get to 25, 26, they're going to be top players. And that's when I think you'll see Chelsea start to win things again.
Did you think it was the right appointment, putting him in charge?
It's hard to say, but part of me, because Frank Lampard is my idol, so I think it's a great start. It's a good start somehow.
I think he's, you know, it was a bit open to how you would expect Chelsea to play this season, because obviously he had the transfer embargo.
Oh, yeah.
And so he couldn't bring in the players that he wanted to bring, or if he had the opportunity to bring players in, he didn't have that opportunity to do it at the club. And I think that was a big reason why they took Frank Lampard, because he worked with Jody Morris at Derby for the season previously, which they've done very well considering the team they had. And, you know, Jody Morris's background is with Chelsea, with the academy there. And it was obvious that the plans were to try and get some of the players into the first team from the academy this season. So the likes of Tomori, Abraham doing very well, Mason Mount doing very well, you know, players that started the season. So I think that was the reason, you know, I think as the Chelsea board, they probably thought, we're not going to do so well this season, but long term, it's going to be beneficial for the football club. But I think he's actually doing better than what they expected him to do, because I thought, if Chelsea finished in the top four this season, I thought, it's a great season. But
especially
they've been in the top four.
Too,
yeah, and I didn't expect them to be in the top four as early as they have been, to be honest. I thought, you know, it would take a while for Frank Lampard to settle down and get used to, you know, his role at the football club, and maybe they would finish a little bit stronger. So, high hopes for them still.
Seems so long ago now since Abramovich came in, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you almost forget that he wasn't always there.
Yeah.
No, exactly.
Yeah.
I think I missed him he came 2002. I left 98, so four years.
Yeah. Never met him though.
Yeah, a few times, yeah. He's all right, to be fair. Yeah, I spent some time with him when I worked for Chelsea TV on the pre-season tour of America.
Okay.
And they went to, I was out there for 2 weeks. They went to Miami, LA, Where else was we? Philadelphia. And there was one more play. So I was staying in the hotel with the team and everything, but with Chelsea TV. And I spent quite a bit of time in his presence, and he was all right. He was very normal.
Yeah.
His bodyguards were they're idiots, right. Like, but because they think, you know, they got a bit of power in that, and they're trying. Yeah. Like, you're going to walk. He wants to have a conversation with you. You go walking over to him, and the bodyguards are stopping you and all this shit. You're like, what are you doing, you idiot? Do you know what I mean?
I met this bit of that over here too, isn't there?
Oh, it's a surprise.
Yeah.